I should be careful. High security here.
Kinos' father owed a lot of drachmi to their leader, a man named Ipatos.
Come on.
Off the
Come on. Ella. Ella. Come on. Found him. Come on. Yeah.
Tere, did you happen to have any Athenian armor in your shop? It's for Diocles' burial.
Timotheos can buy his father's armor back if he likes. Won't be cheap, though.
What do you mean?
Diocles sold me his armor not too long ago.
Timotheos said his father's armor was stolen.
Well, I have it here and I'm no thief. I also have another set of Athenian armor. Not as nice, but it'll do for the burial.
I'll take Diocles' armor.
You'll find it in the chest upstairs. Pleasure doing business with you.
I should be ready to meet Echinos and Timotheos at the funeral.
Come on.
There you are. Do you have the armor I asked for?
I have your father's armor, Timotheus.
That's great news. Where did you find it?
I went to the merchant in town. The armor wasn't stolen, Timotheus. Your father sold it.
That doesn't make any sense. My father wouldn't lie to me. What matters is you got the armor back. Thank you, Mystios, truly.
You're welcome.
Now I just need an offering of oil for the ceremony.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. It means a lot. I should go dress my father.
Mystios! Any news?
I took care of the bandits, Lykinos.
I can breathe easier knowing my pater has been avenged. There's no chance those Malakas had any explanation for their heinous actions.
Your father owed the bandit leader, Ipatos, quite a bit of a drachmi.
What business could he have had with that scum? What matters is that they've paid for their crimes. Thank you, Alexios.
Now you can focus on mourning.
I should probably let Timotheus know about this. If you're staying for the burial, I'm sure an offering of wine would mean a great deal to my pater.
Timotheus asked me to pick up oil as well. Where can I find the offerings?
He did? I mean, you should be able to find what we need at the docks.
I'll be back soon.
This area will be well defended.
Got the oil. I could get the wine, or just head back to the burial.
Of the offerings. I should head back to the burial.
Hey, you!
How could you be so stupid? More bloodshed, Lykinos?
Pater's death needed vengeance. I took care of it.
You took care of it?
You really think you will end there? Alexios, you agree with me, right?
Timotheos is right. Provoking the bandits was short-sighted.
If I recall, you were less concerned when you were getting paid.
Someone else's father probably just died because of you. Then it'll be your head next.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
What? No, why would you say that?
You've been nothing but cruel to me since I got here.
I'm sorry, Lykinos. I just don't want to lose you too.
We only have each other now that Pater's gone.
We should proceed with the burial. Did you find an offering?
I brought you both what you asked for.
Then thank you from both of us.
I can't thank Alexios myself.
I did what I could. I hope your father's journey across the Styx is peaceful.
Lykinos, come. We must prepare the altar.
In a moment. I'd love to see you once more before you leave town. Please, find me after the ceremony.
See you around, Miss Dios.
My dear Alexios, over here. Do you have a moment? I was hoping to have the chance to thank you for all you've done.
What did you have in mind?
Poet may be my day job, but there's more to me than that. I'm also a very talented cook. Allow me to make you a fabulous meal.
I'd like that.
Great. There's just one thing. I'll need a little help hunting down some ingredients. Literally.
You're treating me, you said.
After all we've been through together, surely you can agree that I'm a lover, not a fighter.
For how many bandits I've killed for you, it's pretty safe to say you're not a fighter.
I have to compensate somehow.
What do you need me to hunt?
This dish calls for venison. Any of the beasts wandering nearby should do. Meet me at the cliffs near the Ipernistra camp once you find some.
I need to stay hidden.
Let's ride!
Oh! Hella. Ja!
Let's go.
It's a start, but Licinus will need more.
There should be plenty of meat for Licinus' dinner.
Ella.
Beautiful view.
It certainly is. Did you manage to hunt down our food?
Here's the meat.
Perfect. I'll get started. Please, make yourself comfortable.
That was delicious.
I told you I could cook. Was the food worth it?
A few deer are no match for a mighty Mystios.
I wish I had your skill and confidence.
Fighter or not, I'm sure it takes a lot to be a renowned poet in Athens.
I may have exaggerated my accomplishments as a poet a bit earlier. The truth is, I'm not just home for a visit. I ran out of drachmi in Athens.
Why lie to your brother about this? Or to me?
Timotheos has always been my father's son. In every way. They both fought for Athens, they both worked in the family business. Timotheos' path was never for me, so I left for Athens to strike out on my own.
You're afraid of what he'll think?
He'll say it was irresponsible of me to leave in the first place. And he's right. I don't have any drachmi, or means to earn it.
You're an amazing cook, Licinus. If you're looking for a way to make a living, you should start there.
I guess everyone needs to eat. Besides, any skill that impresses you is worth pursuing.
You've never answered my question, though. Why lie to me about your career?
Isn't it obvious? I didn't want to appear a failure to you. From the moment I met you, I knew you were amazing.
I'm just someone who's had to fight every day of my life.
Still, you saved my life, Alexios. I'll never forget that.
Well, I'm glad I did. This has been nice, Licinus.
It really has.
I don't think I should brave that water in this boat.
Alexios, there you are.
Am I interrupting?
This is where I used to practice sparring with my father. After he retired to the fishing business, he lost interest. But I kept up the practice on my own.
Sparring without a partner isn't a real challenge.
Are you trying to goad me into a sparring match, mercenary?
I might be interested in some friendly competition.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Are you scared, Athenian?
Fine. Let's spar.
Let's see what you've got. That's all you got?
Ha, I'm just getting started. Filthy Spartans!
Timotheos, are you okay? You fought well, Athenian. Timotheos? Timotheos, what are you doing?
No! Stop! Stop! No! No! Stay back! Get away from me!
I'm not going to hurt you.
Don't you get it? I might hurt you if you don't stay away.
You're not going to hurt me, Timotheos.
You don't know that. I don't know if I could stop myself right now.
Even if you did try to hurt me, I'm more than capable of fending you off.
You're underestimating what I'll do when this happens.
Timotheos!
No, no, no! Stop! Stop!
Just breathe.
I'm okay. Thank you.
You're safe, Timotheos. I promise.
I need to be alone right now. I'm sorry.
I should check in on Timotheos and Lykinos at their father's house.
Going out any farther is a good way to get capsized. Whoever did this didn't take anything. Lykinos, are you all right?
They took him. The bandits who killed my brother took Timotheos.
Where did they go?
To the ruins of Mykenae. Please, you have to help him.
Thank you.
I should be extra careful in this area.
Timotheus, we have to get out of here. Timotheus!
Die, Spartan dogs! To the ferryman with you!
It's over.
Where are they? Cursed Spartan dogs. Where are they hiding?
You're safe, Timotheus. I promise.
You! You're one of their spies.
Timotheus! What are you doing?
Lykinos? I'm so sorry.
I'm just glad you're all right.
You saved us once again, mercenary.
In more ways than one.
The famed Eagle Bearer hasn't saved you just yet. It's nice to finally meet the Oclesis boys.
And you must be the man responsible for my pater's death.
Responsible? Your father was one of my best smugglers before he screwed me over.
Our father would never work for you.
He had no choice. Dear the Oclesis liked to gamble. With my support, he could place bad bets all day long and keep that lovely home of yours.
Something tells me your support came with strings attached.
Hardly. The Oclesis and I were partners for years before I killed him. Unfortunately, a man who gambles with another man's drachmi stops being a gambler and turns into a thief.
You got your payment in the Oclesis' blood. What do you want with Lykinos and Timotheus?
I was going to clear the Oclesis' debt through his boys, but you took out my biggest competitor in Corinth.
Glad I helped?
You did me a favor, so I'm willing to let these boys go. To repay what I owe you, Mystios.
He killed my pater! Are you really going to let him go?
Yes, Mystios. Are you going to let me go?
There's been enough bloodshed. You can go.
A smart move. Consider the debt repaid.
Thank you for saving me, Alexios. There's something I've been meaning to tell you.
I need to tell Alexios something too.
I'm sorry for running from you the other day. It wasn't how I really feel about you.
I would never leave you.
What I mean to say is I shouldn't have run from you when I want to be with you.
I'm the only reason you even know each other. The fates have spoken. The gods brought us together. I feel it in the fiber of my soul.
I just like you as friends. Both of you.
I see.
If that's how you really feel...
Well, thank you again for saving me and for everything.
Goodbye, I guess.
Mistios! I pray to Poseidon that one as mighty as you would come to aid us. I nearly lost hope, but here you are.
I was told your village was in danger.
Yes. My brother sailed out to take on the soldiers threatening to burn us out. I take a dim view of piracy, you know. But they ambushed his ship and, well, my brother never saw home again.
Sharks are merciless.
How did you know he was killed by sharks?
I visited your brother's tomb. I'm sorry for your loss.
Thanks. That's kind of you to say.
So are those soldiers still threatening you?
Yes, but I have a plan. I'm going to build a warship. One they won't be able to sink. My village will survive.
You seem determined. What do you have left to do?
Too much. There's a detachment keeping the pressure on us, not far from here. It's hard to gather building supplies while they're around.
So you need supplies, or you need that detachment taken care of?
Well, aren't you as clever as Athena herself? What would you be willing to do for us?
I'll find the supplies you'll need, and leave the fighting to you.
Fair enough. Though, I might need you to take up arms against dryads. I need plenty of olive wood to make sure the ship is solid.
I'll get right to it. I think that's all he needs to build the ship.
This should be all of it.
Thank you! Now there's just one last thing we need. An eye of protection.
For the bow of the ship, you mean?
Exactly. There's probably one in the Ariadne shipwreck. At least if Poseidon hasn't claimed it for himself.
If it's there, I'll find it. Here. Will this I do?
Yes. I suppose it will.
Is something wrong?
I remember this eye staring at me as the ship went down. So many sailors died that day.
You know, there's more you can do with a new ship than just piracy.
I believe you're right, Mystios. Perhaps you'll come to show me wisdom after all. Here, take this. It'll be the last of our spoils.
Thank you. May you find a more peaceful path in the future. I should get back to that strange woman and let her know what happened.
Whoever thought carrying boats across land was a good idea? I met the dead man's brother.
Ah. So why did such a man go sailing in shark-filled waters?
He was a pirate, and he set out to fight the soldiers who threatened his family. They sank his ship, leaving him to the sharks.
That's nearly tragic. So how did you resolve the matter? That is what you do as a Mystios, resolve matters, right?
I dove deep to retrieve the protective eye the new ship needed. Poseidon must have smiled on that, because he enlightened the pirate's brother and set him on a more peaceful path.
I see. That answer is quite revealing of your character.
Why are you concerned about my character?
Something will come of it. Very soon, I suspect. But here, take this for now.
Thank you. Though it sounds like you have more plans for me.
Perhaps. You've proven you could survive the dangers of the ocean. But what about an island of fire and smoke?
I'd like to explore this strange island.
Good. You're very nearly impressing me.
Oh, really? I should be impressed.
I would like to send you to an island of smoke and flame, but an associate of mine still has my key to the vault within. Without it, your trip would be in vain.
Are they as strange as you?
That's nearly amusing. My associate lives in the graveyard you visited for me earlier. He lives as a hermit. He'll have time to talk, even to you.
I'll go reclaim your key.
back. The owl knows. She's Athena's favorite bird, you know.
I'm here for the key to the vault.
Then what are you doing here? That's nearly ridiculous.
So you're telling me it's not here?
I left it somewhere safe. It's near an abandoned camp on Egina Island.
That doesn't sound very safe.
How could it not be safe, surrounded by so many defenders?
Why do I never get the easy jobs?
Who knows?
Rhodotos. What's that island ahead of?
That, my friend, is the famous island of Salamis.
The place where Athens defeated the Persians?
It's in this bay that the great Athenian strategos Themistocles destroyed the Persian fleet and saved the Greek world from annihilation. You don't see many heroes like that anymore.
Thank you.
found the key. Time to return to that strange woman. I found your key. Your associate certainly kept it well protected.
He ought to have. I paid him well enough to do so.
Where exactly are you getting your drachmi from?
I have very few needs and spend only on what I find important. I'm very nearly thrifty.
Now that I have the key, is there anything else I need to prepare to visit the Island of Fire?
You tell me, Mystios. Do you feel prepared to explore the foundry of Hephaestus?
Wait, you're not going to ask me a strange question first?
Perhaps I'll think of one later.
I'm ready to explore that island.
Very good. You are proving your worth.
Am I now? I'm impressed.
There is an island swathed with clouds of smoke, where the earth blazes with fire. It's called the Foundry of Hephaestus. A legendary helmet is kept there. Bring it here so I might study it.
Seems like a dangerous journey for just a helmet.
It's not nearly the only treasure there. You can keep anything else you find.
All right. I'll go to the island and find the helmet.
Με τη δότα, 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 με τη δότα Commander, away! You're released until further orders.
By all the gods, it's hot in here. Hephaestus sure seems angry. I wonder if it's because of the war.
Yeah!
Orophoni was an extraordinary woman born of Andromeda, daughter of the proud queen and king of Ethiopia, and Perseus, the Gorgon Slayer after whom she is named. It has long been tradition that women should marry but once, as virgins. If their husbands died before them, they were to live out their lives as widows. Orophoni defied this tradition to become the greatest grandmother of Hellas. It is said that a warrior woman of advanced age brought so much chaos to the people of Lake Tritonis that Perseus himself arrived to take her life. And some wise people say that was Orophoni enjoying her last act of rebellion. Orophoni's first husband was Pyreres, king of Messene and Sparta. Their sons grew up to be bold princes and kings of Sparta themselves. But Orophoni had a second husband, King Oivalos of Sparta, who would bring her even greater children and grandchildren. Helen of Troy, Castor and Polydeuces, Clytemnestra, and many more were her descendants. Thank you.
This helmet seems common, but it's been carefully hidden. I should get it back to that woman. That burning island and trapped tomb, you could say they were nearly a challenge.
Even for you. You exaggerate, Eagle Bearer. But did you find the helmet?
Of course I did. But how could you have known about such a terrible place? And who are you to send me there?
Who do you think I am, Alexios? Some say I show great wisdom. Others say I am wisdom herself. Tell me, who do you think I am?
You sent me to a graveyard, where I met a desperate man who said Athena herself had sent me to kill him. But I suppose that could mean he only thought you were Athena.
It's unwise to give too much credit to the rantings of a madman.
Then you sent me to a pirate in need, who asked me to help him as he saw fit. Was that a divine test of wisdom, or just practicality?
You sent yourself to a pirate. I merely provided the chance.
Finally, that strange hermit with the key. He was even under a statue of Athena's icon, the Owl. Did you set that all up as a joke, or is there truth in his beliefs?
So many thoughts in that head of yours. It's nearly too much to contemplate. Make your decision, Alexios.
It seems you want me to believe you're Athena. Mysterious riddles, a helmet of all things to find. It's clever, but obvious.
If this is the case, it is I who should congratulate you on your cleverness. Here, show me the helmet.
I hope this was worth it.
You aren't very principled, are you? One who stands for nothing falls for everything. I've seen all I need to. Here you go.
Thank you.
I hope you've gained some wisdom from this journey.
Yes, I've learned that profit can come from the strangest sources.
Aphrodite, Artemis, Athena, mothers and daughters of Olympus, please lead us to safety. We can't lose anyone else.
I'm none of those, but I am Alexios Hemistios. What's wrong?
My people are in grave danger. We lost our leaders and our warriors, and now our hunters have disappeared.
Hunting parties can be gone for weeks before returning. What happened to everyone else?
War. The fight between Athens and Sparta has reached their borders, so the men left to offer their swords. I fear that those remaining will be lost to the sons of Xerxes.
I would not trade our roles in this situation, though killing is my specialty, and I can hunt and track.
Do you deal in advice? I don't know how to address my people. They know something is wrong, and I'm not sure what to do about it.
If you're the leader, then act like it. High road or low road, you must still pick your path.
You're right. I need to make preparations instead of panicking. But then, there's still the missing hunting party. Would you find them for me?
I'll look for the missing hunters.
My cousin Agnodike volunteered to look for them. She hasn't returned either.
Thank you. I can't repay you, so I won't try. Those bastards!
Are you all right?
Do I look all right?
You survived. It's more than we can say for your companions.
That was our warning. First our hunters, then the rest of the village. I need to warn our magistrate about the son of Xerxes and their plans.
And I need to see her about my payment.
You've returned. What news of Agnodeki and the hunters?
Magistrate Perictioni, I have grave news. The sons of Xerxes are preparing to strike. Oh, it's you. Magistrate, this Mistyos saved me from certain death.
For double the reward, I hope?
Finally, someone around here who knows how to use a sword. I've been trying to convince Peri to build our defenses since we first saw the sons of Xerxes creeping closer to the village.
This is my sister, Thea. She considers herself to be acting general of Lalea in the men's absence.
It was your husband who shielded us before. Someone must do so now! Did you hear anything Agnodeki said? If we wait on the gods for help, we will be massacred.
The only language the sons of Xerxes seem to understand is violence.
Mistyos, what if I hired you to protect the village?
I'll do what I can.
Good. Meet me at Kifisos Spring. I have plans for those sons of Xerxes. Good to see your face again.
Yours too.
Lalea is the daughter of Kifisos, god of this spring. It's said that she lives in these pools.
Thea, right? Perictioni told me you've been acting as general. Though, from what I saw earlier, you and your sister don't see eye to eye.
Peri would die folded in prayer before she asked for my advice.
Sometimes we want a comforting voice that says everything will be okay. Rather than to be confronted with harsh reality.
And now we are on the knife's edge, waiting for the slaughter, and we have done nothing. I must prepare myself to fight, and hopefully the others too. Can you teach me?
Your sister says you act like a general. Let's see if you fight like one.
I'm ready. Hey! Ha! I told you not to go easy on me. You hit her! Well, that was humbling.
The sons of Xerxes won't be as kind.
No. It's a good wake-up call. One I wish Peri could have. But Big Sister always knows best.
Sounds like she's always giving you a hard time.
You could say that. Acting like the hero while I do the dirty work.
Now you're the hero.
One can only hope to live up to that title. I've been playing soldier too long, and now I'm stuck in the role of Perseus while feeling like Andromeda.
Yeah.
I seem to recall the legend saying that Andromeda was nude and tied to a rock.
Was she? I'll have to remember that the next time I'm reenacting the myth. Lalea has a rich heritage for theater, though not so much for fighting.
Spartan women are taught to keep up with Spartan men. Lalea seems different.
It is an oversight that I've been pushing to correct. When the men leave for war, our defenses are limited to a few hunters too valuable to leave, or young men who can barely hold a spear.
And now that the hunters are dead,
we're more exposed to attacks from the sons of Xerxes than ever.
I've seen kings and commanders. You share their temperament.
Peri married the governor. I am unwed. Spinsters do not become leaders. We exist on the fringes.
We should get back to the task at hand. There's still a lot to do.
You're right, but it's hard to know where to start. I need to train the others for war, but we are without weapons and armor. No blacksmith. But his daughter is still here.
And what about the hunters you lost?
We need to train replacements. There's also a camp close by. Likely the daughters of Artemis. They are not a friendly bunch, so we've been doing our best to avoid them.
Who should I train to hunt?
I've met with some volunteers from the village. They've got a little experience, but need to have their bow arms straightened. You can find them on the edge of Lalea.
Not sure how useful I'll be to the blacksmith's daughter.
Methialdosa mentioned needing some materials before she can get started. Between you and me, she needs a little push. She's been helping her father at the forge since she could walk, but she still doubts her own abilities.
I'll get to it.
Tell me to make the weapons, but when you have them, ask if I know how.
Oh, who are you?
A mercenary hired by the village magistrate.
Oh, that explains why I don't know you. I'm Methialdosa. Please don't tell me you need new weapons or armor.
I don't, but the rest of the village does.
Oh, that's worse.
I thought you were the village blacksmith. Why are you so reluctant?
I'm not the village blacksmith. My father is, and my brother is his apprentice. I just fetch wood when they need it. Now they all expect me to arm the village.
Are you the only member of your family left?
I'll know when the men return from war. Matter left with the ferryman last year.
Is there any way I can help?
I think Pater left the molds and tools nearby, but I need ore. And even then, I might make something utterly useless.
You look capable enough to me.
There's a difference between knowing how to do something with your mind and knowing how to do it with your hands.
Fair enough. What kind of ore do you need?
Any kind of ore will technically do. But... My pater used a legendary ore when making a dagger for my mater. It is called Aphrodite's ore. Sounds strange, but it's true.
Where can I find the ore?
It's hard to reach. It's down the cliffs at the Persian remnants in a secret cave, just above the water.
Sounds like you've been there before.
I told you, I wasn't the smith. I was there to fetch what Pater needed. I'd go myself, but I need to hit up the kiln.
I'll bring back Aphrodite's ore.
Persians were insane to try to climb these cliffs. That must be the cave. I can see why this ore is named for Aphrodite. That should be enough ore from Metliadusa. Time to head back. I found the ore.
Amazing. I'll ready the molds.
Will that be enough for the village?
It should be a good start. Oh, that reminds me. I have a problem.
You and the rest of Lalea.
I'm just one smith, and I can divide my time between making weapons and armor, but it will slow down the process. It would be faster if I just worked on one. Which should I focus on? Weapons or armor?
We can't kill bandits without weapons. We'll just have to hope their archers have poor aim.
Yes, you're right. Your confidence gives me hope. Thank you for your help.
This is the whole hunting party?
We're all Alea has to spare since the sons of Xerxes killed our husbands and sons. You must be the Mystios Perictioni hired.
I am.
We may not be the big brutes you're used to, but we're versed in killing well enough.
Well, we know how to fish.
That's a start.
We're ready. Do you have everything you need?
Yes. Get your bows and we'll go. Tell me about Alea.
We've been blessed by both the waters of Kephissos and by Aphrodite herself. For she is the source of all beauty.
All settlements need to be near water. Ours just has a lot.
And you fish in the pools and the river?
Kephissos provides us with what we need.
Not enough in there to provide for all of Lalea. That's why we need you.
With the sons of Xerxes so close, is there less game around?
We've been relying more on fish and fruit. It's enough for now.
Animals don't scream and beg for mercy the way humans do. I doubt they interest the sons of Xerxes as much.
They're still food. Perhaps their numbers aren't as high as we think.
They may not have enough archers to black out the sun with arrows, but they do have enough to fill every citizen of Lalea with holes.
Here we are. A great bear is said to live nearby.
Don't mention the bear. I'm already regretting being here.
And relaxed. Your arrow needs to be just below your eye. Exhale on breeze. Aim for the eye, so that you don't damage the arrow.
Die!
Thank you, Mistios. I've learned much from the bow. Aphrodite may provide, but Artemis acts.
Lalea is such a beautiful place. I'm glad I can do my part to take care of it. Thank you.
That should be enough to get you through the week, but there's still much to be done for Lalea. I've done all I can for these women. Time to get back to Perictione.
You can talk some sense into my sister.
I've just spoken with the hunting party. They recovered new enemy arrows near the boundaries of the village.
Scouts. Likely sent ahead to find weaknesses in Lalea's defenses. Of which there are many.
That's what I've been telling Perry! We need to kill those scouts. Even if we do defeat the lion's share of the Suns in battle, the scouts will cut our throats as we sleep!
If everyone dies in battle, there will be no village left to defend. Agnodiki spoke of enemy weapons caches. If we destroy those, we'll cut the legs off our foes.
What did Agnodiki find?
She overheard the Sons of Xerxes discussing supplies they stole from a nearby fortress and returned to their camp.
We need to deal with this now.
Which do we focus on, the scouts or the caches?
I'll take care of the scouts. The last thing we need is an ambush.
If you've chosen wrong, we'll be exposed with nothing to show for it. But if you must go, go now. Are you ready?
I'll see you when it's done.
What is it that Spartans say about shields? With them or on them?
May the gods guide your path and the arc of your sword. Destroying the caches is strategic. Looking for scouts is a waste of time.
Don't leave my sight!
Yeah!
Better get back to Lalea. Hunted them to the last.
I'll sleep easier knowing that.
I still worry about them overcoming our numbers in battle. But thank you. This will change our fate.